After more than a decade in Parliament, former Premier Stephen Marshall is quitting politics. His departure triggering a by-election in the state's most marginal seat, but it's still not clear exactly when he'll go.
Still attracting support from Norwood fans. His heartland of 14 years. Stephen Marshall calls time on his parliamentary career.
It's now time for me to make way for new and fresh ideas.
The former Premier says he made the decision to leave just weeks ago, abandoning his backbench role for no new job or future plans.
I didn't want to look like a former leader that threw my toys out of the cot after losing the election.
It's the timing of his departure. Matters for Mr Marshall to explain. It's unorthodox, if I put it politely.
The father of two went from loyal Member of Parliament to leader of the party in 3 years. His first attempt at becoming Premier in 2014, most memorable for this.
If people in South Australia want change, they want a better future, they want to grow our economy, then they need to vote Labor tomorrow.
Whoops.
And they did, landing him another 4 years as opposition leader before eventually tasting victory in 2018.
I've just had a call about a half an hour ago from Jay Weatherill and he rang.
In his one term in the top job, he saw bushfires, a one in 200 year flood, and a global pandemic.
We are going hard and we are going early.
The 56-year-old admits there have been both highs and lows.
Premier, what's happened?
I'm just going to make my speech. My political legacy really is up to the people of South Australia to judge down the track. Obviously, getting through COVID was a massive milestone, but I think in general, the economic transformation of the state is what I want to be remembered for.
I've got so much gratefulness for what Stephen has provided to me in the way of mentorship and support, backing me in Cabinet.
His resignation will send his electorate back to the polls.
I absolutely love him. So I'm a Stephen Marshall fan, actually.
I think Stephen Marshall did a great job throughout the pandemic, and so, yeah, we'll miss seeing him around in Norwood.
It's a bit of a marshmallow, I think. It was a bit weak. He just followed what everyone said.
I think any politician, when they're elected, should serve out their full term.
But it's still anyone's guess who the candidates will be and when the vote will be held. Stephen Marshall's yet to formally tender his resignation to Parliament's Speaker.
Thank you very much.
Kimberly Pratt, 7 News.
And the stakes are higher for the major parties in the by-election, both desperate to prove a point.
Mike Smithson joins us in the studio. And Smitho, the bragging rights couldn't be higher.
Yes, Will, we know Dunstan is now the most marginal seat in the state. That was made even more awkward for the Libs because their leader not only lost government but came within a whisker of losing his own seat. That political landscape has now changed significantly. The Libs' internal polling shows in recent times ambulance ramping has all the lights and sirens blaring for Labor. So much so that the Libs have now gone from a losing position to a potential winner in Dunstan. During the upcoming annual glitz and glamour of Mad March, gather around footy and the Lib Golf, the Libs are likely to paint the Premier as party boy Pete, while also pushing a much more serious side.
There's no doubt that this will be a referendum on Peter Malinauskas's abysmal performance in leading this state, and in particular, his central campaign promise, which was to fix the ramping crisis.
The key point of difference between the Liberal Party and the Labor Party in health is we've got a plan.
Labor can afford to lose this seat because it still has the numbers, but if the Libs enjoy a sizeable increase, there will be major Labor concerns that that trend will spread. And don't dismiss the Greens either. They genuinely fancy their chances, especially on rental and cost of living issues.